Hey folks, this is Bastion Slot. Welcome back to my in-depth look, joke, and the brand new marine species pack for Jurassic World Evolution 2. In this video, we're going to check out the Nothosaurus, our Sauropterygian reptile from the Triassic. We don't have many Triassic creatures in the game, but Nothosaurus is now one of them. Before we check out any animations and stuff like that, let's have a look at some statistics. So, synthesized dinosaur, inverted commas, releases in batches of up to 6, cost 270,000, appeal 162. So, actually, more Dunkleosteus has really got the short end of the stick in this pack, it must be said, appeal-wise. And you'll see in the cosmetics section, we've both got the Frontier skin for the Nothosaurus with their patterns and their skins, and we also have Nothosaurus 2022, representing, of course, that final season of Camp Cretaceous. If we hop over to Dinosaur Needs, you can see some there. Again, we need the platform, although it has less platform need than the Archelon did. And we can see some base stats there as well. So let's check out this exit animation. These 6 are all Frontier skin ones, and then I've got a little 2022 one to release afterwards. And again, we've got that completely unique sort of music going on, which is really interesting. Let me find one with a pat. I kind of want to get to this one over here. That one looks really cool. So there is our Nothosaurus, our Triassic reptile. Really does have, I've mentioned this a few times now, that kind of otter-esque feel, the way it moves through the water, the way its body moves, the sort of the way the feet and the legs kind of push backwards feels quite otter-like to me. And we've got that slightly long neck, because these were, you know, related to the likes of your plesiosaurs, and these very snaggly jutting out teeth all over the place, primed for catching fish. Now, of course, design-wise, this is ripped straight from Camp Cretaceous. This is basically a one-to-one from the creature as you see in Camp Cretaceous, but with Frontiers patterning over the top, which is a sort of striping kind of effect. I would have liked it to maybe less. They really keep going hard on the splodges, and I'd love them to pull back on that a little bit, but we've got some nice striping there along the back, which I much prefer, and some pretty cool colours. Of course, we'll check all those colours out in the species viewer at the end. This one looks a lot nicer with that single Indoraptor-esque stripe down the middle there. Design-wise, it's not my absolute favourite. I think there's always going to be a little difference pulling from Camp Cretaceous. Things aren't going to, you know, they can't focus on the same things. You know, you want it to look like it's from the show. Yeah, that's a pretty nice looking skin. That's the kind of thing I want to see a little more of. No splodges. It's kind of got this stripy, messy striping. Got this blue in the middle, and then this really nice underbelly coating as well. That is the one straight from the Camp Cretaceous show, of course, but also probably the nicest skin off the lot. Okay, it looks like we've got a social animation playing over here. Nophosaurus 10. We're going to follow you, buddy. Quite like this red colouring as well. That looks pretty great, actually. Again, with the pattern in particular. It's kind of cute, kind of twirling over each other a little bit. You see them kicking off with the legs. Again, it felt similar to the way that otters move. You can see it there again in the distance. It's just kind of spinning over each other, and then they slink out of the way. It's very gracile kind of movement. And I'm going to say it's very otter-like one last time, because it is, but I'll move on from saying that over and over again. Especially when you get this coloration, though. I mean, come on now. Let me see if I can get that in capture mode for you here. Very cool. Nice. It suits them really well. It suits their body shape really, really well. Of course, we're going to see a above ground one as well. You can see a couple of them over here on the rock, but I'll hopefully catch one climbing up there in a second, and we'll observe that one. Okay, with the below water stuff done, let's check out the above water stuff. So we've got a couple of Nophos hanging out on this rock already, just kind of lying there, again, basking, really. You know, the reptiles, they want to bask a little bit in the sun. I've got to say, I didn't really hype it up enough in the Archelon video. This is a really cool addition to the game, and it's something I'd like to see them expand on even further. Again, I'd love a crocodilian or something like that that could utilize this. I think this really opens the door for that kind of thing. Let's see one of these Nophosauruses climb up onto the rock. It's down there at the moment. Yeah, much more graceful than the Archelon was, to say the least. Slowly slinks up. It's funny, you could have this in a regular exhibit and you'd probably get away with it. You know, it doesn't necessarily have to be in the lagoon. It definitely has that amphibious kind of feel to it. Now, what I want to see is if there is a on-the-rock social animation in the way that the Archelon did have. So, I'm going to observe for a little bit and find out. It looks like you can have more of these up here at once, or at least they're approaching from different directions than the Archelons were. Okay, if I had to guess, this is going to be that on-the-rock social animation. We've got one sort of resting here. It just sort of raised its head up there. You see, it's the one that's been sleeping in the last little clip. And this one started to approach from behind. That is exactly what happened with the Archelon animation. So, let's find out. Here we go. Less direct contact that time, just, you know, this is my spot, I'm claiming this spot, get out, which is largely what the Archelon did. What I really liked was as well, this third one that came up here, this one in the middle, kind of looked and stopped and watched and observed what was happening and kind of did a little roar off its own along the way. They sound really cool. They sound quite similar to Herrerasaurus. They've got that kind of breathy, throaty, asthmatic kind of vibe. I've got asthma, I'm allowed to say that. I've got that asthmatic kind of vibe to the way they voice things, which I think makes a lot of sense for an amphibious creature. I really love how you can look at this and then, and you're thrown into this incredible underwater world. It's a very cool thing. Next, we're going to check out how they hunt with the fish feeder. I don't think these are going to hunt anything else. I would be very, very surprised if they hunt the like of the Ichthyosaurus, but I'm going to try it out with a couple different things to see if we have any interactions with other aquatic creatures. But until then, we should have a little bit of a hunt over here. You can do it, buddy. Do it for YouTube. Cool little dive down there, snaps it up, and again, like the Archelon has to take even an extra bite to get it down. Has to take an extra bite to get it down. We're gonna check that out one more time. Not really sure what the camera decided to do there, but there you go, another little biting sequence. Right, so what I'm going to do now is take away the fish feeder and try a couple different combinations. Ichthyosaurus, Dunkleosteus, just to see what combinations we have there, and we'll go from there. So, Ichthy, here you go, buddy. I would be immensely surprised if it can kill the Ichthyosaurus, immensely surprised. But you never know. You never know. Well, it shows what I know, folks. Really surprised by this, but the Ichthyosaurus is indeed being hunted by the Nophosaurus. I'm super curious to see how this plays out. So let's follow along with our Ichthy till we get a better idea of what's going on here. I am genuinely really surprised by that. I'm not quite sure how that's going to work, but I'm very curious to see it happen. I think they may have taken some of the criticisms about the lack of hunting to heart. Fleeing Noph 12, probably this one over here. Now, Ichthy's pretty good. The first hunt, Ichthy tends to get away. It's got a lot of stamina and it's quite quick. You see, it's getting away from the Nophosaurus now. Well, the stamina is about to end. Yeah, oh, it might be in trouble. It might be in trouble. Is Nopho going to give up or is it going for it? All right, we're going through this way, I think. Okay, that was pretty cool, actually. It actually swung around and grabbed it by the beak sort of area. I don't know what else you'd call it, the beak, inverted commas. I'm just going to see that again, because that was very unexpected for me personally. There There you go. Swoops in, bites it around the beak, and then swims away. It's not actually interested in eating it or anything. It just wants to murder the bloody thing. Okay, look, this is a stupid little idea, but I did want to give it a go. So I've got a Quetzalcoatlus broken out of its aviary, currently flying around and murdering the last few remaining guests who, man, remember Quetzalcoatlus? It's so good. I really wish they walked around, but God, the animations on this thing are so cool still. Anyways, if there was ever going to be an interaction between a lagoon creature and an aviary creature, do you know, this would be the time, right? When they're sitting here on the rock. So whilst I'm not expecting anything, I'm going to do a little test and let the Quetzal fly around whilst we wait to see if the Dunkleosteus does anything in the meantime. That's the current plan. Well, I was about to give up, but there we go. Dunkleosteus has begun to hunt down Nothosaurus. So there's our big dunk. Big dunk on the hunt. On the hunk. Oh, wait. Ooh, there we go. Just in time. Da-da-da-da. Oof. Oof. No, the scream. The scream wasn't necessary. Unfortunately, doesn't really seem to be a thing. There's a whole gaggle of Nofos over there on the rock. It's worth noting your Nofos need to be relatively happy or they won't hang out on the rock, so I've had to give them some food and stuff now that we've tested out the Dunkle. The Quetzal just is very near death, 21% health. I'm gonna run it through to starvation, but I'm just gonna mention it now that it does not appear to be a thing. One day, this glorious interaction will happen, potentially, but I don't think it's today. And Quetzal is dead. Right. So, with that knocked off, one last thing we have to do in terms of animations and stuff is have a look at the breakout animation for the Nophosaurus. So let's get high escapes on. Let's make sure comfort is on as well, and let's give that a go. Bonk. And there it is in the distance. Probably not an animation after. Oh, going again apparently. Oh, it sounds much worse for the Nophosaurus than it does for the wall. With the Dunkle and the Archelon in particular, I'm like, yeah, okay, but with this guy, oh, I don't know about this, buddy. Oh, I feel like the spine is shattering. Right, okay. So that's our Nophosaurus. Now let's go check it out in the Species Viewer and have a look at some of the skins. One thing I forgot to show you during the video is, of course, the Nophosaurus actually has a couple of Lux skins, ones that, you know, gleam at night and stand out and glow in the dark a little bit. So I'll show you those two right now. We've got Pelophylax, which is this one here, this blue one. And if we go to the right a little bit, over here we've got Papyrana, which is this big, strong, red, crimson, bloody kind of streak going along the body. Just a nice little addition, yeah. Kind of suits the Nophosaurus more than the others in the pack, I would say. Also, while we're here, I'm not going to go through this in the free update, but this is the first time I've looked at it at night. The viewing dome, which I don't think is a particularly interesting building, becomes much more interesting at nighttime. I think that looks really cool at night. Like the patterning up here and stuff like that, you see the caustics there. That looks beautiful at nighttime. Very the Meg, very Jurassic World the game. And also similarly with the rock pillar, that's got its own lights as well and actually looks more interesting underneath here at nighttime. Just worth pointing out, enjoy the rest of the video. So here we are, we've got a little sitting down animation. We've got several here, you can see it's kind of its ambient when it's up on the rock. Swimming fast, we'll just get sitting for now. And skin colours, so we've got Sonoran Desert, we've got Death Valley, Great Sandy Desert, Champlain Valley, Sala del Huesco, Limpopo River, Killian Mountains, Yukon River. It's really interesting, for some reason, Svalbard. A lot of these, yeah, we've got some couch shading in there, it's more prominent there. Amazon Rainforest, Mangrove Forest, Gambia River Basin. So that is your lot colour-wise, pretty standard suite of colours, looks alright. And then the Nophosaurus 2022, of course, that's the Camp Cretaceous one. Again, I think this may well be the best of the skins. It probably limited Frontier in some ways. They wanted theirs to look demonstrably different. Which is our favourite of these basal skins? Great Sandy Desert, that's probably quite a good base to work from. Okay, and then we've got Rana, which is a blue Indoraptor stripe, and then lots of her darker, sort of muted blue splotches. Looks alright. Carcarana with a dark stripe and lots of orange splotches. Lifobates yellow, like a lightning strike, and some black. That one's pretty cool. Maybe put that on. Ah, that's pretty sweet, actually. That's pretty sweet. Pulcrana, red and blue. Looks quite good as well. Papyrana, which says pink here, and it's just greens on the right. And then we've got Pelophylax with whites and yellows. So, yeah, I quite like the life of it. I think that was pretty cool. It's not bad. I wish there were slightly less splotches, but I like this stripe, and I like the stripes along the back. I just wish things would... less splotches would be nice. You know, we're in a very splotchy world right now with Jurassic World Evolution 2. It'd be nice to mix it up a little bit more. Archlon did a good job at that, I will say that much. But I have one more to showcase. So that was it for the Nophosaurus. We'll be back in the next video with Shonisaurus. And remember, after that, we're also going to check out a full overview of Free Update 7. Excuse me. 7 was a very difficult word to say. And also, of course, a overview of all the new social animations for the pre-existing animals. We've seen these 4 already, of course, these new species, but all the, well, some of the existing marine species also got new social animations, so we'll be checking those out as well. So hope you stick around for that. Throw me a like down below if you enjoyed the video, and I will see you lovely folks very, very soon. Thanks for joining me. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye.